Howdy dig dong do the guys, welcome back to Let's Play Danganronpa. Trigger Havoc! With me, TapersCrazy, well, unless I thought Nagi was apparently just beatboxing in the left there. What is he on, some sort of, like, jackhammer? He's beating me up, but, apparently we're in a fight with Kirigi, because Kirigi is trying to throw us under the bus. But, with sort of the tractor from trying to see who's the real culprit, for now, and see more details about our bodies. Let's continue. We're gonna dive into a blow back to the back of a head she suffered. I wouldn't count it out. I mean, file makes it clear that those weren't fresh wounds. Okay.
Oh yeah, good point. If they were old, I guess they don't really matter.
Okay. Oh. Then we're safe in assuming the blow to the back of her head is what.
Yeah, but everything in this game's there for a reason.
But then, what was the murder weapon? The Monokuma file says she was hit with a blunt object, about as thick as a metal pipe.
Oh. Where can we get a metal pipe from? Doubtful. She would know.
Well, maybe they held it the other way and hit her with the handle.
No way. The balance would be all off. You wouldn't be able to swing it with any.
Oh, Toko's like a scientist on rigging melee weapons.
You if you want.
No thanks. I bet you just hit me with a metal end and call it an accident.
You are not wrong. Oh my god! Jesus!
I feel the same way! Looks like we're on the same page this time!
Oh dear. Why is everyone trying to kill each other? Stop it!
You wanna figure out what killed her, right? It just so happens we already know.
What, do we?
I knew we could count on you!
Is there something that I can't remember in the garden?
Go ahead and tell them, Makoto. Surely you've deduced the real murder weapon?
The real murder weapon. Knife tapped. What about key tied? The titanium arrow. I guess that's the only thing that fits. How can you kill someone with a titanium arrow?
Back of the head with something, and that's what killed her.
Yes. An arrow.
The titanium arrow we found in the locker in the dojo.
Would that kill someone if you whack them with it?
An arrow? That's what the culprit attacked Mukuro with?
Indeed.
What?
There's no doubt about it.
I don't understand, really?
That sounds kind of weird.
Hey! How dare you back talk, monster?
That doesn't make sense to me. Hitting someone with an arrow. I mean, they're kind of thin. With any kind of force, you got to be kind of strong. I don't even if I doubt it, because there's one more thing about that weapon. One more secret. I guess we're about to find out. Bringing it. Please, it will block you. Titanium arrows. Let's have a quick look at the titanium arrows. So, there appear to be 10 in total. Oh, if you tie them all together. I guess.
Bloody duct tape.
That's good. I think it's gonna be the bloody duct tape holding them all together.
Because in the Monokuma file, it said the weapon must have been about as thick as a metal pipe.
Yeah, I'm just getting.
Seems like an arrow would just be too thin.
Oh, I'm pressing my finger. Whoops.
Never mind. No right.
Shut up, Toko. You ding dong. If it is a titanium arrow, it wouldn't be nearly thick enough. Which is why they used. God, way to give the answer away. Spoilers much.
It was in the dojo locker, right?
Jesus. So I assume that if you're playing on like a harder difficulty, it won't give the hints at the end.
Sure?
It'll just keep cycling around.
You don't sound convinced. What's the problem?
Well, in the Monokuma file, it said the weapon must have been about as thick as a.
Yes.
Seems like an arrow would just be too.
There you go! Ding dong! You are wrong! And I just figured it out!
You're right. Just the one arrow would have been too weak. That's why the killer used another weapon.
Another weapon?
Yep.
Inside the dojo locker, we also found a balled up wad of duct tape.
What arrow is he even doing in this place anyway?
Probably uses duct tape to bind.
Yukari comes in. Hey, I like bone arrow. Yukari. Persona 3, get back there.
Together, oh, okay. Using duct tape would easily create a single weapon as thick as a pipe. And that's exactly what the killer did.
It's similar to Aesop's fable about the bundle of sticks.
Oh god, here we go.
Weak, but put them together and they become strong.
Strong.
Teach cooperation.
Damn, that's harsh.
How is it harsh? Are you even listening?
Anyway. God, suddenly she's got all serious. As for who getting a voice all of a sudden.
The weapon in the dojo locker. It was you, Kyoko.
Oh.
I've never been to the dojo.
Oh, you absolutely have.
How can you say that with such confidence?
Because we have proof, of course.
Why? I don't want to throw another bus. Yeah.
What's the matter? Surely you don't intend to protect a murderer. You know what will happen if you do.
Which is she a murderer? Is she,
you
what?
Cover for the culprit, there's only one thing that can lead to the death of us all. Remember?
Of course I remember.
Then show us. Show everyone the evidence that proves Kyoko went to the dojo.
Oh shit. I have evidence. Evidence Kyoko went to the dojo. What are you connected to the dojo locker? Yeah, some bit of a locker thing. Robot key. I don't want to throw Kyoko into the bus. Even though she's doing the same to me.
Right here. The key to the dojo locker.
And how does that prove anything?
Because... I found it in your room.
It was in my room?
Yes.
Trying to play dumb. That key is just the final piece of the puzzle. Your non-existent alibi, your clear motive, your attempts to frame Makoto for the crime. This all proves that you are the true culprit.
I think there's more to it than what's going on here. It just doesn't sit right with me for some reason.
Again, you really are dead set on defending her, aren't you?
No, it's not that I want to defend her.
Yes, you do.
One more thing I need to ask her. Kyoko, I want you to tell me something. Last night, you were in my room, weren't you? Why? What were you doing there?
Probably saving our ass from Rey Mysterio.
I need to know.
I was just protecting you.
No. The waifu bait. Does that mean she? Yeah, she saved your ass. She knew I was being attacked, and she came to my rescue. Could that be when? Should we meet Kyoko? She killed someone for me.
That's enough. The time for idle chatter is over. A verdict is close at hand.
Wait. I'm warning you. Don't make this mistake. I'm not the killer.
I knew you were stubborn, but this is just getting ridiculous.
Really?
It just doesn't sit right with me.
Better than anyone, I didn't do it. Can you tell me I'm wrong?
I should know.
Wait. I should. What? I like when Tagami gets rumbled. He's just like, wait, what? What does that mean? When the body was found. What's that got to do with anything?
Those were...
Body was found. It's gonna have something to do with this. Come on, Aoi arriving the dining hall. Mikoto meets Yves in gym. Don't all find Pegasus in the garden where she discovers the body. Weeks to morning announcements. Well, that's the only thing we've got. I assume it's gonna be take this and put it somewhere else kind of thing. Fair enough.
You should understand that more than anyone here.
What are you hiding?
He's gonna be hiding something.
Something.
I've got to wait for him to trip up over his words or something.
Proof that you aren't the culprit. Is that what you're saying?
You stated a theory earlier.
Okay.
You said I hid the evidence of my crime in the dojo locker. And then left the locker key in my own room.
That is true. Why would you do that?
Could I really have done that?
Wait, Kyoko gave her room key to Byakuya, right? Oh, which could mean... Oh, there we go.
What do you mean?
Shit.
Exactly what I said. I'm not the killer.
I guess we'll take that for now, just in case.
That more than anyone here.
Byakuya, what are you hiding?
Master Master would never hide something from me.
Shut up, Toko. He would.
There's proof that you aren't the culprit.
Okay.
Is that what you're saying?
You stated a theory earlier. You said I hid the evidence of my crime.
Okay, so it's gonna be the second one, I guess.
Lock the key in my own room, correct?
Lock the key in my own room.
Could I really have done that?
I don't know which one to use. The logic's so strange. I'll go back to you when I get it.
There's proof that you aren't the culprit.
Oh, there you go. Lock a key in my own room with the there's proof, but I normally thought it's something like. There's proof on the locker key, that's like an agreement rather than a contradiction, so I don't know, it's just like, it's confusing sometimes the way they word these things.
Because she had given her room key to Byakuya.
I see. So that's what you meant.
Oh, get wrecked, son.
The key to your room.
Then obviously, I had no way of getting in.
Oh, Tagami.
Without my room key, I couldn't have possibly put the locker key in there myself. Am I wrong?
It would appear not.
So what does that mean then?
I'm really starting to understand.
No, that's not actually true. It was a clear contradiction about Kyoko just told us, an obvious lie. But this just isn't like her. To try and save herself with such a desperate lie. Does she really feel that threatened? Because she's the killer? Or is this something else? So there's some deeper meaning hidden in what Kyoko said earlier.
If you vote for me and I die here, the mystery of the school is still hidden forever. Which is why I can't let that happen. This is a trap the Mastermind has laid for us.
The Mastermind's trap. The Mastermind is trying to trap Kyoko. But what if that's not really true? What can I do? Should I do? Should I? The Mastermind's trap. The victim was Mukuro when Kyoko killed her. What does Kyoko really know? What am I supposed to do? Kyoko's lie. I'm the only one who knows it's a lie. I'm the only one who can expose it. Who can I trust? What am I supposed to do? Mastermind's trap.
Trap!
If you spend all your time trying to avoid danger, you'll never move forward. We know the danger. But if that risks me solving the mystery, we have no choice. Am I wrong?
Do I do? I decide right here now whether or not to expose Kyoko's lie.
Run away!
Just run up the stairs. Run up the stairs, and Monokuma shoots me in the back. I don't know. I trust Kirigiri. I mean, she's waifu. I'm gonna let it go. Made my decision. I have to believe in Kyoko. There's no way she'll kill someone. Has to be some secret here. Some of it has to do with the Mastermind trap that Kyoko mentioned.
Does no one have a rebuttal? Have you decided to accept her assertion as fact?
Yes.
I see. So you still refuse to accept it. I suppose we have to admit that Kyoko didn't put the locker key in her room. That it was someone else.
But
yeah.
Who else could it have been?
I mean, Byakuya had a room key, right?
You! What are you trying to imply?
The Byakuya's catering.
From nighttime on, I was with you guys the entire time. I couldn't possibly have killed.
But it's true.
Or put the key in Kyoko's room.
There's got to be someone.
There's only one other possibility I can think of. Someone could have had the key on them, then once they arrived at the scene, pretended to find it there.
Oh, shit.
To be Makoto, right?
I don't see any other option.
Wait a second. You've got it all wrong. Let's think about it one more time. There's gotta be a hidden side to this case.
Huh? A hidden side?
First of all,
there's something off about this entire trial. You all see it.
Yeah, something's not sitting right with me about this trial.
Mukuro, who we didn't even know existed, suddenly shows up dead. And then we're thrown into a trial. And Kyoko even said, it's a trap the Mastermind set for us. So that's why, this has to be...
Okay, time's up.
Oh shit, there is something up.
Huh? Time's up. Class trial's all over. Everyone can...
There is something fishy going on here.
What? Time's up?
Oh shit.
What do you mean time's up? There's no time's up. Since when have we...
It's because you were late. So we had to push back the start time.
Oh,
so
shit.
Then, it's time for voting time, okay? Everyone, please vote using the lever in front of you.
This is horse shit. Oh, shit. They're gonna vote for me. How did I get A on the last one? That doesn't make any sense. What? I did terrible.
Who will be chosen as the blackened? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one? Hey, hold on. What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
Monokuma, you little shit stain. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. What did I get found guilty? But wait, it's not me, so he can't execute me. What? You think I'm the killer?
Sorry, man.
Sorry. Yeah, it's sorry. It's all your fault.
Everyone, you're wrong. You put it all wrong. I didn't do it.
Yes,
good job, everyone.
Good job.
Yep. I got it right.
No, I know that's not true. None of this makes any sense. It's all trials that make any sense.
Hey. Makes perfect sense!
Sing.
So same as always. So suck off the other class trials and I'm going to end it the same way.
Chills.
It's time for a hot pounding positive fulfilling punishment.
But wait, why do I... Oh, Kirigiri. You threw me under the bus, you bitch. Kyoko.
I don't expect you to forgive me.
I know,
I know this is all my fault.
Kyoko.
Let's give it everything we've got.
I'm gonna haunt the shit out of you.
Time.
Especially when you're in the shower. On your head. I assume that'd be difficult. So does that mean I'm still alive?
What's this? What's going on? Hey, what's that?
Yeah, it had to be.
This is
alter ego.
Alter ego? Is this some stupid virus from that stupid guy? Must have found it when he invaded my network. Damn it all now! I don't believe this!
It seems
you finally made a miscalculation. No. You miscalculated from the very beginning.
What the heck?
What was that?
In other words.
What I'm saying is, you shouldn't have underestimated us.
Hmm.
Why are you talking like you've already won? But if a thing, there's a pinch, an itch! Stupid virus is gone now, got it? And so is Makoto. You're gonna get to smash him flat, but you're never gonna see him again. Waste away the garbage trumpet! In a way, that's an even better special punishment! Oh-ho-ho! But it's still not enough! I'm still not satisfied! It's gonna bring despair to the rest of you! Bring despair to the entire world!
I'm not very good at doing a Monokuma laugh, I'm sorry.
Is he gone?
Hey Kyoko, what's the meaning of all this? Just what the hell is going on?
Calm down.
It's okay. Another one's being trapped this time.
In other words...
Now some masterminds that's ensnared.
What did you say?
What are you talking about?
So...
You'll understand soon enough. Very soon indeed.
Just tell everyone, man. Stop being so cryptic. Now is not the time for happy memories. Massive high school towers over all the other buildings in the bustling urban area. It's like the school stands at the center of the entire world. Wait, what? What's Peak Academy? Brings in top students from every field imaginable. A government-funded school of privilege. They say if you come here and manage to graduate, you'll be set for life. With hundreds of years of tradition, it sends a cream of a crop into the workforce every year. It's built to raise hope in the nation's future, which makes Hope's Peak a pretty fitting name. There are two things you need to attend this school. One, you have to already be attending high school. Two, you have to be the very best at what you do. No ordinary student could enroll here. The only way is if you're scouted by the school itself. And standing right at the gate of the ultimate school filled with the ultimate students was me. Why? What? Where am I? Look at my head resting on a hardwood desk. My body felt heavy. It wouldn't be weird for me to zonk off in the middle of some boring class or whatever, but what was I doing sleeping here just now? Was that in a classroom I'd ever been in before? The heck is going on? Have we restarted the game or something? Oh, no we haven't. Finally! I could finally feel my mind and my body start to come back together again. And then, I was awake. Oh, was this just another dream? A dream inside a hopeless nightmare? No, this isn't a dream. I could tell because the stench invading my nostrils was too powerful for a dream. What an awful smell. It was in a vast dark cavern with a barest hint of light seeping in. Trash was piled high all across the area. Must be some kind of underground garbage pit. Heck of a situation to find myself in. Was this the beginning of my problems? Is it going to be stuck in here till I wasted away and died? No, I can't let that happen. After what my girlfriend went through to save me. Remembered all too well what had happened. Alter Ego saved my ass. And used up the last bit of his strength to do it. So I can't give up now. For myself. For my friend. Believe in the heart of the cards. Yugi, get back to Yugi. And with that, the pursuit of my survival began. First up was to start looking for a way out of here. Door, obviously. Rattle, rattle. It's locked. Rattle, rattle. No matter how many times I pushed or pulled or kicked at it, it didn't budge. Getting out of here isn't going to be that easy. If I'm not getting out of here anytime soon. Decided to look around for some food. There's plenty of food here, but it's all rotten. But that was pointless too. Next, I search for some water. I'm not sure which liquids I can drink. Which ones are an all-round bad idea? Again, pointless. It's like I'm blocked in on all sides. Still not enough reason to give up, because I'm still alive. As long as I'm alive, I'll never give up. Never surrender! After making that proud declaration, the next thing I decided to do was... go to sleep. My sleep was deep and uninterrupted. It was my only way to preserve all little strength I had left, for not being able to eat or drink. I can't be sure, but I think at least a full day has to have passed. All I did was sleep and sleep. It's like I was waiting for some kind of sign to come falling out of the sky. However, fell from the sky wasn't a sign. Not exactly. And we'll find out what fell out from the sky in my next episode, because I'm out of time, so... thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all...
in the next video.